Nigel, talk us through that one.
Probably look at it as a game of two halves, isn't it? I thought we presented lots of problems to them in the first half. Scored two really good goals. Great start. Jared Bowen getting in, obviously. We thought they'd change their formation maybe a little bit, which they did do. Very big side, as you can see that. Mm-hmm. Jerry gets in, gets off to a great start. Our second goal, great bit of interplay. Passed the ball nice and brightly to create a situation for Fraser Campbell to score. We could have had a few more opportunities as well. So made the players well aware at half-time about complacency, make sure we start the second half. We didn't want to make it a battling game. From the start, we didn't want to make that happen. We lose the ball from the kickoff. They get the ball forward, and from there on in, they've got the ball forward. Obviously, they've scored a goal after a couple of minutes. Poor mistake, you know. Goalkeeper's been fantastic for us this season. Let's give their tails a bit of a lift. And then when we look at the second goal, if the referee was in a position, you can't blame the referee. If he was in a better position, he'd actually see that there's a foul for a high foot. So it's not to do with the referee. Obviously, long throw, we talked about the threat they'd be from corners, free kicks and long throws. It's gone in. Obviously, we've cleared the first bit. It's a high foot, and the lad then gets the opportunity to shoot. It's going miles wide. He gets a deflection and goes in the other corner. So you can turn around and say maybe that was a little bit unfortunate, but that got their tails up. They got the ball forward, which we knew that was going to be that way. We prevented them from doing that in the first half. Second half, they got the tails up, got the ball forward, and it was more of a challenge in second half for us, because we didn't pass the ball nowhere near the level that we need to go and do, because we couldn't get hold of it. And yet, Jackson Evans got an unbelievable chance towards the end. Good cross goes on. He's totally unmarked inside, you know, 7 yards out, and he heads the ball wide. So it's frustrating, because we were looking to win the game, and obviously we put ourselves in a good position to go and win it with the first half performance. But obviously a couple of early goals in the second half has got Rotherham's tails up, and the game ended up being a game that we didn't want to go and play with. It was like a battling game. We wanted to play like we did in the first half. So it was very frustrating, because it was an opportunity for us today, and we'd put ourselves in a good opportunity, and we haven't capitalised on it.
Yeah, because you mentioned there about it being a game of two halves. Certainly one characteristic from the first half, the amount of space we was given in our own half to pass the ball around and dictate where we wanted to go, and then all of a sudden Rotherham didn't really give us that opportunity to create those chances.
No, as I said, we knew we needed to pass the ball, and we did that, you know, sufficiently well in the first half. Second half, we couldn't get a grip of the ball, and they were very direct in the nature, and their tails were up, because obviously, you know, we've gifted them the first goal, and the second goal was, you could class as being unfortunate, but then obviously then they tied it back, and they've got the ball forward, and you know that the way that's going to be, it's going to be a challenging game, and it took us a while before we could actually put a couple of passes together, and then when we did, we've actually put ourselves in a good position with a cross going in there, and we've not capitalised on that.
Yep. Does this little miniature break come at the right time then for the players, for an opportunity to sit down and have a look at what's gone wrong in the last couple of matches?
Yeah, well, there you go. I mean, what we'll do is we'll sit down and reflect, and then we'll get ourselves back together again, and look to go and attack the second half of the season, or the remaining 14 games of the season.
Jared, your analysis for today's game?
A game of two halves, I think you can call it. The first half, you know, we got their team in, and it looked like they had five centre backs on the pitch, and you know, in the first half, so they wanted to shut up shop, and they didn't do that. I think we were, you know, even without the ball, I think we were good, and I think with the ball, we showed a lot of credit. We weren't great, we weren't at our best by no means, but you know, that early goal we got, kind of, that's what we said before. We said, you know, let's get an early goal, let's try and put them to bed as early as we can, and you know, going into half time, we're 2-0 up, and you know, we were obliterating them, really. They didn't really have many chances. And then, you know, come out the second half, we start poorly, we give them a foot back into the game. And, you know, they changed their system, and we, you know, I don't think it took us too long to, you know, react to their change of system. And I said, you know, we were lucky in the end to pick up a point, because they were, you know, they were coming at us like we never saw. So it's majorly disappointing. You know, we was at home tonight. We wanted to bounce back from Saturday and pick up 3 points, you know, to keep us up in that playoff, you know, contention. It's 2 points dropped, but you know, the playoff isn't out the window. We only need another good run, you know, to take us right back up there. So, you know, our minds are all still positive, where we've come from to where we are now. I think we can look back at, you know, a lot of pride with everyone involved, you know, all the coaching staff, the gaffer, all the players, from where we were to where, you know, the talk of playoffs is, you know, we can look back at that with a lot of pride. But yeah, tonight is, it's a hard one to take, because felt like we were in so much control first half, and then you know, to drop the 2 points, it's disappointing.
Yeah, but it's one of those games where you can evaluate and look to bounce back from it pretty easily because you know you won't want it to happen again.
Yeah, I think we done it to Birmingham away when we played Birmingham. Was it 2-0 at half time, and then, you know, went 3-2 up and then went 3-3. But that was like a game of two halves. First half we went out the races, second half we came out and scored, you know, three goals. So I guess it happens sometimes in football, but, you know, we've got to learn to, you know, not let them have a foot back into the game, because all they wanted to do was, you know, play long ball, and we're not that kind of team. We're not a long ball team. We like to play, you know, nice creative football, getting players in, which I felt like we were doing, especially in the first half. In the second half, we didn't really get a foothold, and that's, you know, that's disappointing for all of us.
Yeah, but was that based on how Rotherham reacted in terms of the tactical change? Do you feel that was the main catalyst?
Yeah, I've half time it was 2-0. We thought, you know, they have to change something here, or the, you know, this could be six, which we were saying. You know, we said we wanted more, you know, 3, 4, 5 more goals, because I feel like we definitely could have. And then they changed, and like I said, it just took us too long to, you know, react to their shape, and we gave them a foot into the game. You know, we gave them two cheap goals. You know, when the gaffer spoke before the game, you know, I think it was the first goal when he went wide, crossed it in, and that's what they said they were going to do. And, you know, the long throw, we worked on the long throw, comes out to the edge, maybe there's a high foot, you know, sometimes you get them, sometimes you don't, and then it's a deflected shot, so it's, you know, it's one of them goals that's awful to concede, like, you know, just a deflection, just, and you just see it rolling into the back of the net, and, you know, their tails are massively up then, and we're all, you know, deflated, because we've gone from 2-0 up being in control of this game to all and being scared of, you know, losing the game. But luckily we didn't lose the game. It's not a good point, don't get me wrong, it's not a good point. It's 2 points dropped. We wanted all three tonight, and we should have, but, you know, we've just got to evaluate the game and get ready to go again.
Yeah, but one ingredient you need in response is goals, and you've taken your tally now to 16.
Yeah, that's always nice, especially, you know, after, I think it was a couple of minutes, I scored, especially with the right foot. I've been doing a lot of work with Tony, the coach who I'm close to, so it's nice to see, you know, when you're doing stuff a day before a game on your, you know, going down outside on your right foot and then coming out onto the pitch, you feel confident, you know, taking it on your right foot, so it's nice to get another goal. And, you know, there was a bit of debate. I think Fraser even said to me that it was my goal for the second goal, but, you know, I thought I was offside, to be honest, so I didn't want to celebrate and get the goal chalked off. But, you know, Fraser's already said that it's mine, but it's been given as is, so we're not gonna argue about it. We'll have one each.